Now I would like to move to fiscal calendars. Okay, this was a frequently requested topic that we cover fiscal years, because of course some of you may have fiscal calendars in your company, so your business year or fiscal year starts with, say, April. Okay, so of course in this scenario, the standard calendar won't be enough, and you need to add a few things to your calendar. Luckily, this is quite easy in Power BI. It's actually very simple, so you can do it for sure. This is my calendar. Okay, now this was the first part of my calendar. So this is what we had before. We covered that in number of webinars. Okay, so you have your date, and then you have your years and so on and so on and so on. Now we have a second part of this calendar, which is, you know, the fiscal calendar. Okay, so my fiscal calendar starts with the fiscal year. Okay, this fiscal year is, how do you get the fiscal year? Okay, or maybe I should start with month. Okay, it's probably better. I'll just start with month number. Okay, now what you need to do is you need to get the month. So the function month will return the month number from the date. Okay, so this is your normal month number, just returns the month number from your date. So March 3, April 4. Okay, now what you need to do, what you want to have in your fiscal calendar is, say your April is start of your fiscal year. Okay, so this function now must return 1 for April, 2 for May, 3 for June, and so on. Okay, and this is exactly what this function does now. Okay, so we will still use the month, okay, but we will not return the month number from April, which is 4. We need to shift this date. Okay, so basically you just shift your whole your dates for the number of months. Okay, and I have this number, so this would be, for say, this would be, say, 3. Okay, this means that you know, March will be your first month. Okay, so this is this number. Okay, instead of, so because I did not want to, you know, put number 3 everywhere just hard coded, we prepared, actually Mark did this thing here. So he set up another, as you see here, it's actually we just stored this info in a measure called fiscal shift. Okay, so this measure now actually has the value of 3 or 4 and so on, and we are just using this measure here in the formula. Okay, so this is maybe just because we will of course share all this with you, and then you will just go, I will show you, you will go in the calendar options. You see there's a small little table here, and yeah, you have this value of your shift here. Okay, so this is it. The function that does this is called edate. Okay, so you need to use edate whenever you shift this. So you need to shift your month number. Okay, then you need to shift your year. Okay, because it's not, because for example February can still be last year's you know, fiscal year. Okay, so that's why you need to shift your year numbers, month numbers, all with this function edate. Okay, now the fiscal month, the name of the month stays the same, right? It's still April. Okay, so you just format your normal date and up to 3, just get the 3 letters, for the name of the month. And then for everything else that you want to have in your fiscal calendar, all the numbers basically, you just need to shift them. So you need to shift the quarters, they're not the same, and you need to shift your fiscal year month as well, okay? Fiscal year month would be 22-01, meaning maybe April, maybe May, maybe March, depending on your shift, okay? And that's it. Once you do this, you get your calendar that now looks like this. Let me show the calendar. So now it has a few more months here, and our Mark has actually packed this quite neatly here into a folder called Fiscal Calendar. So you can just, you know, place all of your new fields here. Okay, so this was first part of the trick. Okay, for those of you who will study this from our webinar and so on, you'll see a small table here called Calendar Options. We are building this for something else for the next webinar, okay? Because we also want to have an option where you can simply switch from normal calendar to fiscal calendar, right? Everywhere in your reports, like, you know, your charts will switch and tables will switch from the calendar view to fiscal view. So we are building this already for the next webinar. And now here you see this fiscal shift. Okay, so this is what you need to set up. Okay, right. So use -3 for April, right? So April is 4, -3 will be 1. Okay, April will be your first month in your fiscal year. Okay, this was the first part, that was setting up your fiscal calendar. Now you have it here, and second part, and I will this is the last thing that I want to show you. Okay, what about the measures now? Now you have a calendar that has, you know, your normal calendar, and then it has fiscal month. Okay, do you need to change anything else, or will your reports just work after you do this? Well, not necessarily. So your basic measures will probably work, but if you're using things like year to date and other, you know, year to date and then like full year calculations and so on, then you will need to amend those a little bit. Okay, so here on top you see the normal calendar, January and so on and so on. Now we can switch to year to date. Okay, of course the year to date in a normal calendar, okay, so these are just my normal year and normal month, and here below I have my fiscal year and fiscal month, okay, the two new columns that we have just calculated with the DAX function, with the e-date function. Okay, so now you see it goes from July to June. Okay, this is not completely right. Why? This is now the trick. Okay, so what you need to do now, you see here, for the normal measures, it's okay. Just normal values, you know, just they can be just shifted, that's it. But if you have your year-to-date calculation, then you need to do one more thing here. So in your measures, you need to add, so you can still use the dates YTD function. It calculates the year-to-date. However, there's another option here, another parameter for this function, right, which is end of your period. Okay, so in my case, because it's March, so it's it needs to be 3, right? Okay, sorry, 4. No, it was sorry, it was okay, but just my values are somehow strange. Not sure.
Actually, it was correct. So this one for the end of year, and you should just place third, so the March, but 31st, and the same for the comparison measures. So that parameter, oh, the dates here to date.
Yeah. Okay. There are also, of course, others. I just did this for actuals, right? But of course, we have two measures, and now here the visual has the plan and forecast measure. Thanks, Mark. it looked very weird. Okay, but I just wanted to make this point. Okay, that you need to amend your measures and make sure that you will calculate your year to dates and full years and so on with the right with the right months. So use this function. Okay, so now your year-to-date measures will be different, and that's why I now have two measures in my model. Okay, I needed to duplicate my measures, okay, which is kind of the simplest way, but you know, my initial measure was like this, month date, year to date. So you see dates YTD, it's exactly the same function, only this time click back to my fiscal measure. Okay, it has this additional, I'll just put it back to the six so that it looks nicer. And yeah, so this is the change without the parameter, with the parameter. Okay, so to recap, for the fiscal years, add those measures, add those columns to your calendar. Okay, add those measures. We'll just share the DAX, but you can do the same thing in Power Query as well. In DAX, use the edate function to shift your calendar for, you know, the right number of months, and that's it. And then just repeat all the measures that you will need in your reports. Okay, that's number one. Number two, make sure to check all of your year-to-date calculations and maybe some other time functions as well, that you'll add up the right things. That's it. Otherwise, this is quite straightforward. And yeah, for the dynamic axis, use the dates in periods function, okay, where you can just shift, you can dynamically return as many periods as you would like, you know, starting from the start of year for a number of periods, or starting with the end of year, going, you know, a few periods back. That would be an option for the rest of year, right? You take the end of the year and then say, you know, minus maximum of your date, for example, and you'll get the rest of your year, okay? Or do minus 13 for 13 months and so on, or, you know, five would be in the future, right? So five from this date, like 5 years, okay? Yeah, or into the past with a minus here,